Welcome to BHSR VLM Degree College. So in this session, I'm going to talk about the data structures. So data structures is comes under the second BSc Computer Science in the fourth semester. Okay, paper name is data structures. Okay, so in previous class, I was discussed about the sorting techniques such as bubble sort, and also in previous class, I was discussed in this. Now I'm going to talk about the selection sorters. What is the selection sorter? So what is selection sorter? And what is the use of the selection sorter? So will you tell this in this chapter here? Okay. Okay. So we've talked about this sorting techniques and selection sort and the insertion sorts and bubble sorts. So these three are called as a comparison sort. So when we want to performing this. Selection sorting techniques or insertion sorting technique or bubble sort technique, we have to compare with the neighboring nodes here. That means we have to compare with the sideways values here, and we have to, if it is the, we want to compare with less than with the less than with less than greater than values with the left to right values. If the less than always. The smallest value is always placed on the left side, and the greatest value is always placed on the right side. So this comparison going on the process of the selection sort technique, insertion sort technique, and bubble sort technique. Okay, so in the same process also, we are going to implementing the sorting technique, that is we called as a selection sorting technique here. Selection sorting technique here. So let us see. I want to implement the selection sort technique. So using this some unordered list here. So in the selection sorting techniques, we have to find the smallest value in the sorting, and we have to compare with that value. And if you want to take any value of the unsorted list and compare with this remaining numbers, and if it is the any smallest value will be appear here. And we have to compare with that values, and the smallest value you have to find this, find that, and swap that to two values from the separate value and the smallest value here. And later we have to select the another value, and also we have to compare with this all the elements of the sorted list, sorting unsorted list here, and any number is smallest number, you have to swap the values. Okay, if any number is greater than values, then no need to swap the values, and we have to select the next number and also compare with the remaining numbers. And if any number is smallest value, that value will be swapped to the next position, and we have to compare with that again and again, again and again. This process is going up to the sorted list is obtained here. For this purpose, we have to use this sorting technique, that is called as a selection sorting technique here. Okay, let us see. Okay, the definition will be given here. Smallest element is selected and swapped with the leftmost element. Okay, so we have to find the smallest value in the ordered list, unordered list, and we have to that value will be smallest value. We have to swap that value here, and if the greatest value is available, then we have no need to change the their position here. So that's why we have to swap the values. Those values will be the smallest value here. Okay. So for this implementing the selection sorting technique, you have to take some unsorted list here. That is called as a 14, 43, 27, 31, 10, 3. Okay. Okay, so this is the unsorted list. Using this unsorted list, we have to follow the selection sorting techniques, and we have to the unsorted list can be transferred to the sorted list here. So that's why we have to following this algorithm. In this algorithm, the smallest element is selected and swapped with the leftmost element here. Okay, so this is the all the time I'm taking this unsorted list. That means the numbers 14, 33, 27, 35, 10, 3 here. So that's why I'm taking same elements here. to implementing this. So to selection sorting technique here. Okay. For this first step, we have to find the smallest value. We have to select the any value here. First of all, we have to select any value here, such as 48, 43, 27, 35, 10, 3, whatever it may be. We have to select the number, and we have to compare with the remaining elements with that number. Okay, if any number is smallest value, that value will be swapped here. Okay, so we have to select any number. Okay, so I am selecting only the initial number, that is for 14. Okay, this is the starting number, that's why I have to select this number, that is called as 14 here, and 14 will be selected here. And using this number, you have to compare with the next value here, that means 33 here. Okay, 14, 33, that means 14 is less than or equal to, less than 33. Condition is true here, then 14 less than next number 27. So we have to select the smallest value among these numbers. So actually we have selected 14 and compare with 33, 27, 35. So compare with 33. Next 35. Condition is for true. Okay, so next number is 10. 14 is 10. So 10 is the smallest value here. And again, we have to compare with this, that the remaining element, that is for 14 is 3. And in this case, similar scenario, we have to compare with these two values. So these two values are the smallest value with the 14 value. That's why this condition is in this section. Condition is wrong. In this section is also condition is wrong. Okay. So whenever we select the 14 number, that value will be, you have to select this all the elements of the remaining here. So that's why we have to select the 33, 27, 35, 10, 3. But here the smallest value is 10 and 3. Both 3 two numbers are the smallest value here. And then we have to compare with this the two smallest values here, that is called as 10, 3 here. The 3 is the smallest value here. 3 is the smallest value here. Then we have to replace with this number. This number to here, and this number is going to here. Okay. So this is the smallest value. That's why we have to swap this values here. So that's why we have to select the next statement, which one is 3 here, 3 here. And the remaining elements are same here. It is called 27, 35, 10. And the value will be coming here. It is called 14. Okay. Then we have to omit this number. Already we have to select the first number and we have to select the second number. Okay, so that's why I am selecting this number. So that's why it's called a selection sorting number. I am selecting this one, 33 here. And 33 can be compared with the 27, 35, 10, 14. Okay, not for the 3 here, because of the 3 is already evaluated. That's why no need to check this condition again here. Okay, so 3 is already successfully placed and you have to compare with the 33 with 27. So it is false here, and also you have to compare with 33 and condition true. 33 with 10, condition false, and 33 with 14, condition is also false here. So here there is a 3 numbers are available here, that is called the smallest value to compare with the 33 here. So that is called as 27, 10, 14 here. We have to select this only. We have select only 3 numbers, that is called 27 and 10 and 14 here. 14 here. And we have to find the smallest value between these 3 values. That is called as 10 here. That is called as 10 here. That's why we have to swap this values here. That's why we have to swap this values. So compare this here. And it is again comes to here. And again comes to here. Okay.
So that's why we have 3 will be placed here, 10 will be placed here, and 33 is placed here, and the remaining number is 47, 55, and 33 will be placed here. The 14 will be placed here. And for this, the two numbers are in sorted technique, and you have to select the next number, that is for 27. You have to select this number. What is that? You have to select this 27 number, and you have to compare with 27 with 35, 33, 14 here. Okay, so 27 compared with the 35. That means 27 is the greatest value, 35. And 27 is the smallest value to compare with 33. And 27 is the smallest value here. Okay, that is called 14 here. So, when compare with this 27, this is the circle number. And we have to compare with 35, the next number. It's not possible here. And we have to again compare with these values. And again this compare this value, because of these two values are greater with the 27 values. Okay, and that's why we have to select the minimum number, so that is called the smallest value. So compared to these three values, the smallest value is 27, 14. That's why condition is wrong here. One of the condition is wrong, but because of this will be the smallest value with compared with the larger value. The selected number is 27 and the smallest one is 14 here. So that's why condition is false. Whenever the condition is false, we have to swap these two values here. Because of the here, there is a one chance of the, there is a one number with the smallest value here. That's why we have to directly swap these two values here. Okay? If the smallest value is more than 2 here, we have to compare with the smallest value here. But here we have to select the only one is the smallest value here. That's why we have to directly swap that value here. And so this value will be, this value placed and we have to place this here. That's why the shortened technique will be coming here, 3, 10 and 14 will be placed here, 14 will be placed here. And we have to compare with 35, 33 and the last value will be placed here, 27. Okay, so in this scenario, I am already successfully selected here 3, 10, 14. So, omit these 3 numbers and you have to take this 35 number. Okay, next number will be take this 35 number, and 35 is compared with 33 here. Okay, so this is the smallest value, and 27 is also smallest value here. Okay, and compared to 35 less than 33. Is false. 35 is 27. Is also false. Okay. So compare these two values. What is the minimum value? The smallest value here. The smallest value is 27. The smallest value is 27. That's why we have to swap this value to 27, and we have to swap this value here. Okay. Then 3, 10, 14, and 27 will be placed here. There is two numbers available in the case called 33, 35 here, and 33 is 35 here. Sorry, 33 is less than 35 here. Whenever the condition is false, then no need to change here. Okay, then no need to change here. If the condition is false, we have to swap the two values here. So that's why in this process, then no need to change this any values here. So the last two numbers having the same values. And the shorting, the final result will be comes here like 3, 10, 14, and 27, and 33, and 35 here. So this is the final shorting certificate. This is using this selection sorting between peers. So this is we call as a selection element here, that is called selection sorting technique here. So in this scenario, we have to select the smallest value here. Okay, so finally we can print the 3, 10, 14, 27, 33, 35 is the final result will be placed here, and this is the wanted output of the program here. So that means all the numbers can be placed as a ascending order, that is called 3, 10, 14, 27, 33, 35 here. Okay, so this is we called as a selection sorting technique here. Okay, selection sorting technique is also very easy while performing these operations. While you're using this any unsorted list, using unsorted list, you can follow the selection sorting technique, and you have to unsorted list can be transferred into the sorted list here. So this is the sorted list here using the selection sort here. And one more time I will discuss and explain about this selection sorting technique. So selection sorting technique and bubble sort and insertion sort and selection sort, these three sorts are also called as a comparison sorts. These three also are called as a comparison sorts. So in this process we have to compare with this the neighbor value and the neighbor element, and if it is the smallest value, you have to swap that values, swapping that values. If it is the greatest value, then you have to whenever the condition is true, you have to no need to change here. Whenever the condition is false, then you have to directly swap this values here. Okay, so one size selection sort here, selection sort technique. Okay, so this is the smallest element is selected. We have to select the smallest element and swapped with the leftmost element. And swapped with the leftmost element, so such as for example 14, 33, 27, 35, 10, 3 here. So in this selection sort, we have to select this any number. First of all, we have to select any number from this unsorted list here. And by default, all the members can be take this first value, that is called as a 14 here. Okay, so in this 14 technique, we have to say this, compare with these three values, and we have to select 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total, we have taken 6 values, and we have to select the first element, or first element, or whatever it may be. We have to select any element in the unsorted list here. By default, all the members can be take the only the first element value, that is we call as 14 here. And 14 will be compared with the rest remaining values, that is called 5 elements. That is called 14 will be selected values and compare with 33 and 27, 35, 10, 3. And all the numbers we have to select this is compare with this values, and those values are smallest value with the selected values. That values will be taken here. So then the smallest values are available here, and again we have to compare with the smallest value between the again smallest values here, that is called as 10, 3 here, and finally we have to select this the very smallest number, that is called 3 here, and 3 will be placed in this first number, that is called 14 here. And this process is going up to obtain the shorter technique here. And we have to using this technique, I'm taking this some example like this 14, 33, 27, 35, 10, 3 in the unsorted list. Using unsorted list, we can transform the unsorted list into selection sorted technique using the selection sorting technique here. Okay, selection sorting technique will be taking the first element is the selected area, that is called selection sort. Okay, we have to select the first element as the selected number, and these values are compared with 27, 14 compared with 35, 14 compared with 10, 14 compared with 3. Okay, so whenever the condition is true, you don't need to any change where the values here. Whenever the condition is false, and you have to take the two values here, because of those two values are the smallest values here. Okay, in the selection sort or insertion sort or bubble sort says what here, whether the smallest value is always placed on the left side, the greatest value is always placed on the right side. Okay, that is the main aim of the in this sorting techniques. using sorting techniques, we have to sorted the given answer list here, and we have to say take these two values, that is 10 and 3. In the 10 and 3, 3 is the smallest value here, so that's why we're swapping the two values here. And that's why 3 will place it here, and 4 will place it here. And 3 will be over, and we have to select the next number is what is it? 33. 33 is also compared with 27, 35, 10, 14. Here, there is a 3 numbers, the smallest values are available here, that is called 27, 10, 14 are available here. In these 3 numbers, we have to select the smallest value here. That is what is the 10 here. So 10 is the smallest value between these three values. That's why we have to swap these values from here, and value will be placed here. So then 3, 10 will be placed here. These two are placed as a sorting technique. And the remaining numbers 27, 35, 33, 34 here. And select the again first number is the 27. And 27 is compared with the 35, 33, 14 here. Okay, 35, 33 are the biggest number to compare with the 27, and the final will be only 14 of these, the one of the smallest value here. And then no need to compare the smallest values here, yes, because of the it having the only one smallest value, that is what 14, and 14 will be replaced with 27, 27 will be replaced with 14 here. Okay, that's why 14 will be placed here and 27 will be placed here. Okay, after 3 values are sorted list, and you have to set the 3 values, that is what I say, 35, 33, 27, and these values are compared with 33 and 27. These 2 values are smallest values here. These 2 values are, that is what, 33, 27 is also smallest values when you compare with 35. And you have to select the smallest value, that is what, 33 or 27. 27 is the smallest value, then you have to swap these 2 values from here, and this will be placed here. That's why 3, 10, 14, 27 will be placed here, and the rest remaining 3 numbers will be same here, that is for 33, 35 here. And compare with these 2 values, 33 is always small, 35 is always small here. Whenever the condition is true, then no need to change here, and the condition will be placed here. Then there is no element to compare with this selection sorting techniques. Then the final result will be appeared here, that is called 3, 10, 14, 27 and 33, and 35 is the final answer of this program here, of this algorithm here. Okay, so insertion sorting techniques and selection sorting techniques and bubble sorting techniques. So these 3 values, these 3 sorting techniques are comes under the comparison sort here. Okay, I hope that everyone can understand this selection sorting techniques, and tomorrow I will talk about the with new different selection sorting technique, and we have to copy this code, and we have to within your running notes here. Okay, thanks for watching this class. Have a nice day. Thank you.